War never changes. On the news, it became apparent that there were sightings of flashes, blinding flashes, and sounds of explosions. Confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania. We evacuated immediately, heading for Vault 111. A stampede of footsteps surrounded us. The sounds of sirens constantly blaring. Past houses, through the woods and towards the entrance gate to the vault. Many unfortunate people were stuck outside, who were refused access. The sky was a beautiful, vibrant shade of blue. A sprinkling of white fluffy clouds were present. The trees, saturated in colour. The sound of birds chirping happily, blissfully unaware of what was to come. Such a contrast. We made it to the vault entrance and awaited to be taken down. And that's when we saw it. Over the hills, a blinding flash of light, and in that same moment, for a split second, absolute silence. Suddenly, an overwhelming thunderous sound erupted, shattering our senses. A bright orange wave of light ripped through the skies that originated from the explosion and cascaded towards us. It was closely followed by a giant wave of thick black smoke. Tearing towards us at great speed, the ground shaking. Luckily, we were lowered into the vault just in time so that the wave of destruction passed over us. Hi, welcome to the vault. Don't be alarmed, you'll settle in just fine in no time, I'm sure. It's pretty wild, isn't it? Everything that's been happening. And I'm sure things will level out eventually, but it might take some getting used to begin with. The scale of events that have happened, it's like nothing we've seen in our lifetime. That goes to show how quickly some things can change. And when we return to the surface, I imagine it will be somewhat a wasteland. The explosion was pretty devastating. I'm pleased to see that you made it in one piece anyway. Quite a lot didn't make it, but we're quite lucky, really. And I will just give you a check over later to make sure that you're all there. You never know how it can affect somebody, physically or mentally, but yeah, it's hard to believe that not long ago everything was relatively normal and we had no idea what was to come, but usually that's how life happens. Either nothing for a long time or all at once. But I'm sure that we'll make it through. I see that you've got a pit boy as well. That's really good. That will help us on our journey if we get separated. But it's pretty hard to make it out there without one, I'd imagine. And make sure that you've got all your settings to how you want them, because you never know. You don't want to come into a situation and regret not having the settings that you wanted or that helps in your situation. But is there anything I can get you? We don't have a lot here, but it helps to prepare before we reach the surface, just in case. Yes, well, you might not want it right now, but take one of these, just in case. It's always better to have one. I know sometimes I think that I'm not hungry or thirsty, and then all of a sudden I'm absolutely ravished out of nowhere. Walking will do that to you as well. And I'm sure when we reach the surface, it might be quite a shock and you'll need some energy. So take it just in case. So if you wouldn't mind, I'm just going to give you a health check to make sure that you're okay in body and mind for when we approach the surface. If there's anything that you would rather not answer, just let me know and we can work around it. So, first, an easy one, your full name. And quite a rude question, but your age. Excellent. So now I just need to check your weight. Could you just step on the scales for me just there? Thank you. And if you could just tell me the reading. Okay. Excellent. And what was your previous occupation? Wonderful. And your area code. Okay, so you went too far from the vault. Excellent. So hopefully that would mean that you had minimal radiation exposure. Very good thing. And are you here on your own or with family? Right. Okay. Can you confirm for me what year it is? Yeah, that's correct. And do you suffer from any of the following conditions? Heart disease? Stroke? Diabetes? Are you asthmatic? Okay. High blood pressure, do you know? It might have been a while since you last had a health check, but we'll have to just go by your previous results. Okay, and epilepsy? Okay. Had you been taking any medication? Right. No, that shouldn't be an issue. Do you have any known allergies? I'm sure we'll come across one at some point. Do you regularly exercise? Yeah, you're rather fit and healthy. That's great. That's really good. And from a scale of 1 to 10, how anxious would you say you're currently feeling? Considering the circumstances, I would say that's relatively normal, to be honest. It's kind of a tough one, that one, because after an event just like what we've witnessed, it would be quite high, normally anyway, so I'll probably ask you that one again in a few days to come and we'll just track your progress. How many hours of sleep do you usually get? But don't worry, it's not uncommon if you don't get much. Even I myself don't get a lot of sleep these days. Sometimes if we think that we need to sleep and we put pressure on ourselves, it's much harder. Sometimes it's easier to accept that we may not get great sleep, and then sometimes it tricks the brain into giving into it. So, do you suffer from many headaches at all? Do you suffer from them recently? And how about before the explosion? Occasionally, right, okay. again, it's hard to judge whether that would be an issue because headaches are very common. And do you suffer from depression consistently? Do you have bouts of depression? Yeah, understandable. Again, you'd be surprised, quite a lot of people have bouts of it now and again, and it's okay. It's okay to feel like the world is closing in on you sometimes. But there's always a light at the end of the tunnel. And as we'll find out soon as we reach the surface. And do you suffer from... do you have a history previously with any mental health conditions? Yes. Again, sadly, there are quite a few people that struggle, and it can be tough at times, but ultimately it does make you stronger, and it's something that we would rather be without, but sadly it is quite common, but if it helps, you're not alone, so... And have you had any negative thoughts recently? Okay. It's quite a vague question, so don't worry too much. And how many people did you come into contact with before you reached the vault? I know it's quite a tough one, especially when you're fleeing for your life. Right, okay. We'll say within 2 meters. Approximately. Yes. There must have been quite a few around. And do you have any signs of a cough or cold? No, that's great. You're doing really well so far answering the questions. I'm sorry if some of them are quite intrusive. It's quite important that we find out if there's anything underlying that we may have missed as well, especially when it comes to radiation, you know, physically. We need to make sure that you're fit and healthy as possible before we go outside, as it is a slight risk. Okay, we're nearly done with the questions, so did you come into contact with anyone that you may suspect has a cough or cold? I know it's tricky, you can't exactly ask people. Right. No. And it would seem that you wouldn't have come into contact with them for very long anyway, so I don't think that's an issue. Any confusion or dizziness at all? That's to be expected. Again, we will review these in about a week's time and track your progress and see if anything's changed. Are there any gaps in memory of recent events? Any blank spaces? Right. So, just as you left the house, things are a bit fuzzy. Yes. That's probably relatively normal. When a traumatic event happens, sometimes our brain can phase it out to protect ourselves. So actually, it's not always a bad thing, it's just our brain trying to keep us safe. Can you recall for me today's date? I actually struggle with this, even if I know it, and it's written down somewhere. I usually forget it later anyway, so don't worry too much. Okay, that is correct anyway. And who was the last person you remember seeing before you entered the vault? So mostly just strangers. Right. Okay. And when was the last time you were particularly angry about something? Yes. And how did you cope? Did you act out on your anger, or did you just deal with it in your own way, quietly? Yeah. That's good. You have very good emotional control, but sometimes it is healthy to just go for a run or something to deal with it. Okay, excellent. I think that's fine for questions. I'll just finish writing up some last bits of information from your answers. Sometimes the questions can be more intrusive than I'd like, but you've done really well answering them all. I know it can be tricky. Okay, wonderful. So what I'm going to do now is a neurological exam, just to check your responses and make sure that there's no signs of a potential concussion or anything that may become quite serious down the road. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to shine a torch and I want you to follow it with just your eyes. So keep your head still and just move with your eyes, okay? So keep your head still for me. That's great. Okay. Right. Now, I want you to focus on me and I will move the torch. Okay, wonderful. Okay, now what I'm going to do is cover one of your eyes and just check the other eye with my torch. So I'm just going to cover your eye now. Very good. Very good. Okay, and now your other eye. Sorry, it might be a bit bright. You're doing really well. Okay, wonderful. Okay, now what I want you to do is stare at the pictures behind me, and then when I signal, then look towards me, okay? So look at the pictures for me. Okay, and then back towards me. Okay, great. Now, I want you to look towards me and then look towards the pictures. So, keep looking at me and then towards the pictures. Okay, great. Wonderful. Okay, now I'm going to cover your eyes, one at a time, and I want you to do the same thing, but this time don't move your vision, just keep focused on the pictures for me, okay? So, looking at the pictures now for me. Okay, great. And now, and can you look at the items on the shelf for me? Okay, great. Wonderful. Have you had any previous problems with your sight before? No, okay, that's great. And do you get headaches a lot when you try to read something either close or far away? Okay. Are you sensitive to temperature at all, either the hot or cold? Right. Okay, and can you please now raise your eyebrows for me, as if you're surprised? Okay, great. And now can you frown for me while scrunching your nose? It's hard not to do it myself when I ask somebody else to do it. That's excellent. Right, okay. You're doing really great so far. So next, what I'm going to do is just check your hearing. And how has your hearing been? Have you had any troubles at all? Right. Okay, that's good. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to cover each of your ears at a time, and I'm going to say three words, and I want you to repeat them for me in the same order that I relay them. Okay? Okay, so. Vault Blue Cola. Okay, wonderful. Now I'm going to do the other ear. Cola Blue Vault. Okay. That's great. I know it's quite a silly exercise, but you'd be surprised how much it can tell me. Now what I'm going to do is just, I'm going to click near your ear and move away, and I want you to tell me when you stop hearing the clicking, okay? Or when it becomes fuzzy. Okay. Relatively normal. It's kind of a trick question because you don't really stop hearing it if you've got decent hearing. Okay, I'm going to cover one of your ears and do the same thing, okay? So ask you to close your eyes for me, and I'm going to do the clicking once again, and I want you to tell me which direction it's coming from, okay? So close your eyes. And you can open now. Okay, great. And close them again for me. Wonderful. Okay. Just check that we've got everything. Okay. Now, I'm just going to check in each of your ears, just to cover all bases, so if you wouldn't mind. Seems to be fine. And now your other ear. Okay. Seems to be all good. No cockroaches or anything nasty in there. Seen quite a few about the place. Seem to be giant mutant cockroaches actually. Okay, so that all seems to be relatively normal considering the circumstances, which is good news. I've seen quite a lot of people less fortunate than yourself. So we should be okay to return to the surface as soon as you're ready. You seem to have escaped most potential side effects, but because you live so close to the vault, I think that might have had something to do with it. You have had minimal contact with radiation, so that's wonderful. It's quite a nasty thing, really. I've seen some really unpleasant things, and you're one of the healthiest, so that will do you very well. Before we ascend to the surface, is there any questions that you might have? Any worries? As far as things go, it should be relatively safe now, and you've been through the decontamination process as well, so yes, just as you came in, yeah, it's rather cold, wasn't it? Okay, so let's just do a little inventory check before we continue, and make sure that all your settings are correct on your Pip-Boy as well. I'd hate for them to be slightly askew when you need them most. So you've got your Pip-Boy, we have weapons here if we need them, which we most likely will. Yes. We will most likely find more supplies on the surface, but it can't hurt just to carry things as we're going up, just in case. It's a while before we encounter many. There will be others on the surface who we'll be looking for supplies as well. Yes, there will be all sorts of things that we will come into contact with. But don't worry. We'll just take it as it comes. Okay, well, if you're happy with everything, I suppose that we better get going.